Hey, this is Reverend Dr. Marisha, your Lioness Queen. Happy Saturday. Happy Saturday. Welcome to our weekly Manna Motivation. Be sure to subscribe to this YouTube channel. I definitely appreciate the support. And thank you for tuning in today. And so this week, we are still talking about bleeding on others, but now we're going to shift to healing. And so the question that I want to ask you is, are you willing to heal the wound? And that's a question. Typically people say, yeah, I want to be healed. I want to be done with this. I want this to be over. But there is still a peace within us, I have to say, that for some reason still wants to keep it going, still wants to keep the wound open in a way where it's either, you know, hurting the other person to make them feel bad, to make them look bad, you know, but in the same regard, it hurts us as well. And so that's what we're gonna dig into today. And so you know I love starting out with a quote or a poem to get, you know, an episode started. And so this week I found a quote by a woman named Ann Wilson Schaff. I don't know if it's Schaff or Schaff. So sorry for butchering a name, but the quote says, there's so many ways to heal. Arrogance may have a place in technology, but not in healing. I need to get out of my own way in order to heal. Yes, that is a powerful quote. I truly believe the first step in recognizing your own arrogance, your own pride, is letting go and really, you know, realizing that healing starts with you. Deliverance starts with you. Moving forward starts with you. Letting go starts with you. And the only way to take that step is really to acknowledge that you have a wound. Like Miss Anne, you know, said in her quote, sometimes we need to get out of our own way. And do you ever feel that way? Sometimes you can feel that, and sometimes you don't even realize that you are the one that's blocking yourself from healing, from moving forward, from letting go. And I'm sure you've heard it before, but, you know, we are our biggest enemy because we don't really want to do the work. You know, healing takes work. Healing takes time. Healing takes waiting, right? There's a process in the waiting and doing the work. You know, it admits that I have an issue. I have a problem. I have a wound that needs to be dealt with. And you have some issues, some problems, some baggage. But guess what? We all do. And we have to come to the realization that I have a wound. And it is, unfortunately, it is our pride that keeps us in bondage. It is our pride that keeps us from applying the word of God to our life and to our wounds so that we can heal. And a few weeks ago, I interviewed a Lioness Queen by the name of Mrs. Claire Davey, such a beautiful spirit. And she said something about pride, and it really stuck. It really stuck in me. And she said, pride preserves the past. Let me say that again. Pride preserves the past. And this is so true because it preserves us from doing the work. It preserves us from really digging in deep and really applying the word, applying that antiseptic, right, in order to clean and really disinfect that wound, right? It preserves us from acknowledging our wounds and that our wounds, unfortunately, are still bleeding on other people. And so the first step, I would say, in healing, you know, from bleeding on other people is admitting I have a wound. And this is no different. When I was thinking about this is no different than admitting, as if you had an addiction, if you have a problem, it is a starting point. It is a place where you accept where you are at this point in your life and you surrender the spirit of pride, right? Whatever that thing is for you, whether it is the spirit of lust, whether it is the spirit of fear, whether it is the spirit of pride, whether it is the spirit of laziness, right? Whatever it is for you admit that thing in a way to say, and you say it out loud because when we speak, right, our words have power, right? It says life, the word says life and death are in the power of the tongue. And so when we speak, we have power. So when we speak that thing and say, I have an issue. When we say, I am walking in the spirit of fear, you're admitting, guess what? I have this wound, and it is a place where you accept this space. I'm accepting this space that I'm in and this place in my life that I'm in. And it's okay, right? That I it's okay that I can't do this on my own. It's okay that I don't know how to get out of this space. It's okay that I might need help. And we have to realize it's okay to not be okay. That space is something that we all have been in. We all have been in, right? In some form or fashion. And so many people feel like saying that I'm not okay, it puts them in this, I would say, this vulnerable space, right? They a vulnerable space where they're scared to put themselves in, and especially if you have experienced abuse, especially if you have been mistreated, if you've been backstabbed, cheated on, lied to, when you have lost trust in people, I'm telling you, when you lose trust in people, then even your darkest hour, your darkest moments, your darkest times, you're trying to figure things out on your own. But when you have a wound, when you have baggage, when you have residue, right, from a traumatic experience, especially from a traumatic experience from someone close to you, someone who was an authority figure, maybe a parent, a supervisor, an older sibling, an uncle or aunt. Sometimes you cannot manage the wound by yourself. And sometimes you need someone with expertise, right, to help you care for the wound, help you to clean and apply that antiseptic to the wound. Because I'm telling you, when we leave wounds open, and in a physical wound, if you think about a physical wound, especially the depth of the wound, depending on how long you've had it, it easily can get infected. Easily can get infected, but so can your emotional wounds. Your emotional wounds can get infected when they're not tended to, when they're not dealt with, when the word isn't applied to that wound to heal. Because when the word goes in deep, it applies that antiseptic, it applies that medicine in a way, right? That helps it to heal, that helps it to come back together, right? It helps it to mend and reshape the muscles and the tissues and the blood vessels, right? And so sometimes we need help with our wound. We need help to care for those wounds until you can learn how to care for the wound on your own. And it is these emotional wounds, I have to say, that you must admit are there in order to begin to heal. And I remember the first time I experienced a deep emotional wound. And that was when my ex talked, the first time he said he didn't want to be married anymore. And that wound cut me deep. It cut me to my core. I'm telling you, that wound, it was the deepest wound I have to say that I've ever experienced in my life. And I tried my best to act as if it didn't bother me, but it did. I tried my best to wear a mask. Almost like a band-aid, right? To cover up the wound and act as if I was okay when I really wasn't okay. I was in emotional pain. I was in emotional distress. I was hurt. I felt abandoned. I felt like trash. I felt rejected. I felt like, what was wrong with me? And all of those feelings came from that emotional wound. And I left my wound open, right? I left my wound open for a while, and I never really acknowledged that the wound was there, but it was there. That wound was there, and it was a space, I have to say, where it was almost as if because I left it open, it became infected. My mindset became infected in a way where I felt bitter, not better. And the bitterness that I had was because someone said that they did not want to be with me anymore. And I have to say that once I got to a space when the Lord was really trying to heal my wound and have me do the work and applying the words to that emotional wound, the one thing that the Lord the one thing that the Lord, and it stung, let me tell you, sometimes God's word will sting, right? And this is something he said to me that really stung. And God said to me, he said, I give everyone free will, right? I give everyone free will. And people have the will to change their mind. And I understand this is a marriage. I understand you took vows. He said vows, you said vows. I understand it's till death do us part. I understand what you thought in the beginning was a match made in heaven and you were meant to be together and this was the right one for you. I understand all of that, but I gave everyone free will. And in that free will, people have a right to change their mind. And I'm like, Daddy, I don't understand that right there because, but he vowed to me, like he made a commitment to me. I feel like we gelled together well together. I feel like we've been in this thing for a minute. Like, well, what's he gonna go out for? Like, I'm a good one. I'm a good woman. I'm going down my laundry list of all of the things that he could check off. I'm a good woman, right? And God said to me, but he can change his mind. And I was like, woo, that stings. That right there. Oh, that stings. I'm telling you. But again, when you apply the word, when you allow the word of God to go down deep and cleanse and apply the medicine, apply the ointment, right? That is needed to heal the wound can be healed. And so the question is, have you ever been in that space, right? Like me. Have you ever been in that space, right, where it's easy to bleed on other people, And I have to say, when my wound was still open, it was easy for me to bleed on other people. Although for myself, I put a band-aid on it because I didn't want other people to I didn't want other people to see my wound. I hid it for a long time, but I'm appreciative that, one day I opened up. One day I told a friend and said, hey, I'm real, you know what? I'm really not okay. I may be acting like I'm okay, but I'm really not okay. And if you're in that space right now, say that to yourself. It is okay to not be okay. Say it again. It is okay to not be okay. And I think as Christians, We have tried to preach that we shouldn't have certain feelings. We've tried to preach that we shouldn't think certain things. You know, that God created us as human beings, but he, you know, but you can do it. You strong. You have the word of God. But in the same regard, you're human. And God created you human. He didn't create you as a superhuman, but he created you as a human, and he created us in his image, but he created us in a way, right? We are a product of his creation, right? But we're also descendants of Adam. And unfortunately, Adam's tainted blood runs through our veins, right? And that blood creeps into our subconscious. It creeps into our mindsets in a way that the human side of us sometimes wants to run havoc, right? This flesh right here, it is hard to tame this flesh. That's why the word says we need to renew our minds daily, right? It's hard sometimes to tame this flesh because it's, I always say it's like a flabby stomach, right? A flabby stomach takes discipline. It takes time. It takes waiting. It takes perseverance in order to get a flabby stomach toned. Yes, that is how our mindset is. Our mindset, because of Adam, unfortunately, we have that blood running through our veins. So our flesh doesn't always want to cooperate. It doesn't want to always do what it's supposed to do, right? And so this is one of the reasons why Jesus came. He came to set the captives free. Amen. But God knows, right? He knows what we can handle and what we can't. God knows what's going on in our life. And God didn't create us to be this superhuman. He doesn't want us to be a superhuman, because if he created us to be a superhuman, why would we need God, right? We don't have to add the super, because he is a super God. He is a God where nothing is impossible with him, right? He is a God who can be strong in your weakness. He is a God who grants grace when we don't even deserve it. He is a God who can give you a peace when you don't even understand what's going on right in front of you, and when you don't even feel peace. He can do impossible things even when you cannot see it. God is a God who can meet you where you are. And I hope you believe that today, that God can meet you where you are. He met me. He met me in my darkest moment, in the lowest points of my life. And I'm a witness today that if God can do it for me, he can do it for you. But I have to say, this is the beginning. The beginning, the first step is admitting it's okay to not be okay. But on the flip side, it's not okay to stay not okay. You hear me? It's not okay to stay not okay, because Jesus came so that you may have life and may have it more abundantly. Now, more abundantly doesn't necessarily mean that life will always be like Mary Poppins, right? It doesn't always mean that life will be perfect. As Langston Hughes says, sometimes life ain't no crystal stair. But it does mean, but it does mean that trouble doesn't last always. And there is and will be a brighter day. You know, and so what you have to remind yourself, that what you're going through today, what you're experiencing today, is only temporary. So this is the start. This is the start of being open to healing, open to heal those emotional wounds, and admitting, you know what, I'm not okay. And being in that space gives you access so that you can get back the control, right? You can get back to a place where you realize who you are in Christ. I was thinking the other day, we were watching, I can't remember, I was watching a movie. Oh, I know what it was. The movie Wanted. And in that movie, the young man was going into this fraternity, right? And I'm telling you, they broke him down. They broke him down to a point where, and the military does this too. It's like they break you down to a point where you've experienced pain, you know pain, but then they build you back up and give you the skill set, right, in order to work through things. And when I was watching that movie, it was like, man, they're really breaking that man down. And I truly believe sometimes with trials and tribulations that we go through, it breaks us down to a point where we come to the end of ourselves. And when you come to the end of yourself, you realize you can't do nothing without God. You realize that God is all you have and all you need. You realize that you don't know where you would be without the Lord. And that breaking down is a process to build you back up. And so I have to say that once you admit that I'm not okay, it's okay to need help. It's okay, right? Because God is trying to get you back on track. God is trying, he's trying to triage your wound in a way, right? He's trying to triage your wound. And I truly believe he's been giving you his word. He's been giving you medicine. He's been giving you the antiseptic. He's been giving you the antidote, right? He's been giving all those things to you, but you haven't used them yet. And once you figure out what you need for your wound, then God will help you create a wellness plan to get you back on track. Because I'm telling you got to have a wellness plan, a plan to care for that wound so it can heal, so that it can heal from the inside out, so that you will be back and ready for kingdom building. That is the reason why we're here. This is a foreign land to us. This land doesn't belong to us. We're only here temporarily. Only here temporarily. But the question is, are you whole today? And if you need help, it's okay. I needed help at a point in my life, multiple times in my life, let me say. I've needed God's help. And God is ready and willing. He's close to the brokenhearted, but he's ready and willing to help you get back on track. Well, I can't believe our time is gone. This has been a really great discussion, and I truly hope that if you need assistance, that you will seek help. You know, as my Lioness Queen says, pride preserves the past. And it's time to let go of your pride, let go of what you can control, and let God. And if you need help, find help today. You know, I always tell my students, Google is your best friend. Find a therapist. Talk to your physician. And typically, physicians have partners. They have other physicians that they're connected with, and they may have or know a psychologist that they can recommend for you. But get help today. Your healing belongs to you. Your healing is your responsibility. And when you take responsibility of it, that means you're ready and willing to heal that wound. Well, stay tuned to next week. Next week, we'll talk about the next phase of this healing process. Be blessed. Thank you for joining in with us today.